Welcome to another Shopify tutorial. Today, we're going to talk about how to set up Shopify payments and how to test them. All right, so the first thing you want to do is once you're here on your Shopify homepage, you're already logged in, you want to go to settings. And inside of settings, you'll see this one says payment providers. You want to click on that one. And then I've already sort of not tested, but I've clicked on the initial button. But the initial button is gonna be a purple button like this one. It's not gonna say complete account setup. It's probably gonna say, you know, start your account setup or something along those lines. But since I've already clicked on it, it kind of changed on me a little bit. Shopify Payments is probably the most recommended thing that, payment provider that you can use for your Shopify store because they don't charge you any additional transactions fees. Besides the 2.9% plus the 30 cents. If you choose to have a different or a third party provider, then Shopify charges an extra fee on top of whatever that payment provider charges. So it's a very economical feature, I guess, or provider to use the Shopify payments. Now, if I go to complete account setup or manage, you'll see under manage, these are actually the options after you've set it up on what type of cards you want to accept. And then also new accelerated checkouts, which is Shopify Pay, Apple Pay, or Google Pay, which are all pretty fast. If the person who's logged in on their computer has any of those things set up, it's just a click of a button and they just get to the checkout a lot quicker without having to fill out a lot of the information. So it's pretty cool. So let's go back to the setup process. I don't know if this is going to be the same, but I'm going to click on the perp button where it says complete account setup. And it might be the same screen. Okay, it's not. So this is actually the initial screen that you will see once you initiate the Shopify payments. You will need some information from your business, for example, your business type. So if you're individual or sole proprietor, if your business, you want to click that. There's corporation, LLC, partnerships, nonprofit, etc. Depending on what you click, they'll request different information. So for right now, for individual, we just have the EIN number. But if you click on LLC, it just adds a few more. For example, legal business name, and also the EIN number or social security number. It will ask you for the address of your store, some personal details about you, birthday, last four numbers of your social, product details, customer billing statement, banking information, routing account number, and that's about it. So it's just a few information about your business in order to connect Shopify payments. And just as quick as you are able to add that information in there, you'll have the ability to have Shopify payments on your store. I'm not gonna do that for this store because it's just a test store. But once you have that set up, you will get a check mark over here where you can do test or turn on the test mode. When you turn on test mode, you're actually able to run orders on your shop using Shopify's testing credit card numbers. And that way you can actually see to make sure that everything's working correctly. You can actually see how, you know, how orders come in, the type of options that you have when it comes to your orders and your products and things like that. So you can test all those things before actually turning the store live. As far as other payment providers here, they allow you to do PayPal, which you can do the express checkout, which is free. It's a free service by PayPal. You can do Amazon Pay. You can do any third-party providers. So if you have something like, I think Braintree or authorize.net, WorldPay, I mean, there's hundreds of other payment providers that you can connect, but again, it will be an extra charge from Shopify in there. And there's also like alternative payment methods that you can do. When you click on here, you'll see things like Affirm or BitPay or GoCoin. So a lot of the Bitcoin and different monetary or fiduciary money out there, as well as things like Affirm. So Affirm, it's a way for you to do monthly payments instead of having to pay something in full. You can do monthly payments. So you click on that and then connect the Affirm app within your store as well. So besides the alternative payment options, there's also the very last one, which is the manual payment methods. So depending on your store, there might be money orders or cash on delivery or bank deposits. So Shopify allows you to do a lot of different things in here. But if you're starting your own store, it's just a simple e-commerce like we have here with Little Bits Treats, you will just probably have to set up your Shopify payments, make sure you run some test transactions. And then right here towards the bottom where it says payment capture, I would definitely have it set up for automatically capture payment for orders. What that does is as soon as someone orders something from your store, Shopify will automatically charge that card and that person. If you do it manually, then you have a period, I believe it's of 7 days, where you have the actual ability to capture those funds. So if you have it manually, all Shopify will do is verify that that number that the customer inserted was a good number and that they actually have sufficient funds in their account, and that's it. Then you have to go in manually to that order and actually capture the actual payment, the money, in order for you to get paid. So again, the easiest thing to do is just to do the automatic and just save it and have it that way along with your Shopify payments. And then that's it. Once you have that set up and running, it's just a matter of starting getting some traffic to your store. Thank you for watching this tutorial. If you enjoyed this episode, make sure to leave a comment down below if you have any questions on any of the payment providers. And if you like this video, make sure to hit that like button so that YouTube will recommend this video to other people who might be encountering the same problem or want to learn more about payment options within Shopify. And make sure to subscribe because we're going to keep doing some Shopify videos. And eventually we're going to give out some cool videos on Shopify. Maybe some recommending some apps and doing a lot of different things. We just want to get all the basics out of the way. And then we'll have some really cool content for you for Shopify.